Hello and welcome back to Tesla News. My name is Marian and I'm your host today, covering today one big step Tesla has done in the past that now all the other car makers are doing as well. It's not a big surprise. It is something that those car companies have done many decades ago, but Tesla achieved to do it now again, and we will look into that and what impact that has on big supplier companies. Furthermore, we will look into the boring tunnel, and if you do enjoy that, do consider subscribing, and we will start right away here in Grünheide, because it is about German car makers too, because VW is one major player that has now made a change in its strategy. So we will look into that. The reason why I cover that is because it is about vertical integration, and Tesla has been managing that really well in the past decade. And what is actually interesting is that this vertical integration, which means nothing else as people having the ability, or companies have the ability, to produce everything in-house, that is something that they have done in the past. And interesting enough, it has happened in the 70s. 90% of everything that a car maker was doing was produced in-house, and then it got lower and lower and lower. And there's actually a sad truth. Even Daimler had a moment when they were not producing its own electric motor. They were getting it from suppliers. So the percentage of the stuff that was produced in-house went in the entire industry down below to 50%. And when Tesla started doing Fremont, but more and more now with Shanghai, Giga Berlin that we are looking at here, and of course Austin that is built up, we do see more and more vertical integration, more stuff happening in-house, and we do know that Tesla is mastering this process of having the control over the entire supply chain. Of course, Tesla is not perfect as well, and as I mentioned, in the 70s, there was also 10% of the stuff coming from external companies. And in this case, Tesla is in the same situation. We do know that they need the computer chips. We do know that they are not capable of producing all their batteries in-house. But again, that is the new strategy that other car companies are using now as well. They build joint ventures. And we do know that joint ventures, especially when it comes to batteries or long contracts, in the battery segment, are the new norm, and that is what we saw with CATL, which just extended the contract with Tesla. So it is really important for having these joint ventures that Tesla has, for example, with Panasonic, with LG, and then now with CATL as well. This allows them to grow, and this is what other car companies now realize as well, that they have to do that to achieve the amount of cars they want to sell in the electric market. And for companies like Ford, and for example VW, General Motors, BMW, those companies are not only starting to produce the powertrain in-house again, but VW as well invests a lot in the software business. And this is the reason why we see now that officially no one is admitting that, but we all see that the car is getting a software computer. It is a computer pretty much now. And we do see that with Tesla, but no one else has really admitted that this is really the future, and that is the success that Tesla has managed to have over the past 2-3 years especially. And VW is investing a lot into the software team, and they bring it all in-house. They had it in external services or companies before, but they all bring it in-house again, and Ford does the same. And this is a trend we do see here, and as well here, for example, in Shanghai, we do know that Tesla is producing a lot of stuff in-house, but they also have all the companies surrounding them. For example, CATL will be building a really big battery production. We likely might see in Austin more and more suppliers coming. But this, at the end of the day, when the entire production is going, is not going to be bigger than maybe 30% or 10%, depending on the company. So the trend is going back to producing the stuff in-house to have the control over the supply chain. And this is a major move happening because Tesla has moved forward again and the others are following. I'm not saying that is negative, but what you have to watch out is the supplier companies, because they're going to start struggling here. And we are talking here especially about companies like Continental, ZF, Denso, Magna, Bosch. Those are companies that will struggle to survive in the long term if this trend gets even more extreme. And of course, in the future, it might be little startups that are helping big companies to deliver a certain product. So for those suppliers, it will be a hard time over the next decade if this process is continuing. And please let me know what your opinion is. I do really prefer the fact that Tesla is trying to build everything in-house. We do know that it is the way to go. And we have seen that with the FSD development. Just think about it. If that would be not in-house, how we would wait ages to get everything done. And now we are looking as well for the Boring Company. And I want to talk about in a minute what actually no one is noticing what's happening in Las Vegas here. And we do see that there will be a new approach, a new proposal for a new boring tunnel. And so we might likely see in the next few weeks an announcement for a new boring tunnel, which would be very exciting. But not only that, guys, I have recently seen footage from Las Vegas, which I sadly have no right to, so I cannot show you that, but please check it out, Las Vegas Loop on YouTube. You will find footages that are showing that there are a ton of people down there waiting, even waiting in line to get into a Tesla. And so this really shows that the Las Vegas Loop is really playing out the way they all imagine it to be. At the end of the day, the only thing that is still not happening is the full autonomous driving. But guys, we do know that it's just a question of time. And at some point in the next few years as well, this will happen, especially as there are so many safety things happening in the tunnel, which is much safer than on the street with the full autonomous driving. So I hope you did enjoy my video, guys, and thank you for all your support in recent weeks. It is I'm always glad to have you all here, and I wish you all a wonderful day, and thank you for listening today, and take care, guys. Thank you very much.